What's up guys, Walter here, bringing us a brand new video on the channel. So today, you guys see we are naked, but we are on the island map. And you see by the talents, we are going to show you guys how to double and triple structures in Ark. So this is vanilla Ark, of course, I play on Xbox. I am currently in fly mode, and you guys see these are the examples of what we could do. I've actually watched other videos of other people doing it, like on PC, but it's possible to do it anywhere. So, first off, you guys see we have foundations. This is the default foundation size that there is, and then we literally just lowered it and lowered it even more. And with this process, you're actually able to stack all three sizes on top. So this is the highest, which means you go stack another one on top, as you guys can see here with this snap point. Let's see, right there, that snap point, that means you can put it on top, which means with this one you can put one on top and then the third one on top of that, which gives you an extra extra protection, especially when it comes to PvP raiding, because you'll have triple foundation, so they can't destroy foundations like crazy. And over here we'll show you guys how to do the walls. You can see we have three layers of walls on this side, three on that side. We did two on this side. I had trouble doing the third layer, but that's fine. It's still showing you guys how to do it. And then the reinforced wall right here. I'm actually surprised we cannot put a pillar. We could probably put a pillar before, but it shows you can't put a pillar right there. It gives you a lot of snap points for the pillars, you guys can see, only because of the fence foundations. So there's a lot of snap points. And also, as an added bonus, we'll show you guys how to do like the layered ceilings, because I was actually able to put up to 6 or 7 ceilings on this little structure right here because of all the different snap points that there is. Because you see there's three walls on the outside. And I forgot where the other two layer walls came in. They probably came from, I'm not even sure. The wall layers are insane. I was able to put 6. I put as many as I can, and then I just destroyed them one by one and counted them out. And we got down to, I think, 6, which was pretty cool. So I spawned in the resources. I just pumped up my weight on this character only on weight. So we got foundations, pillars, metal fence, defense foundations, metal walls, and ceiling. So you are going to need the metal foundations and pillars, as you guys could see, because I'll show you guys here, there is a metal fence foundation on the outside right here, but you guys could see the cluster that is within the inside of this foundation, which is the main reason why we gotta do this. So of course, like I said, that's why we have these random foundations here, so I could show you guys how to do it properly. And it's pretty cool because when I learned it, I didn't think it was possible. So to do the foundation, of course, put the foundation where you want. If you guys are doing these on official servers and stuff, make sure you start off with thatch. Like you can put your main metal foundation down and then the rest use the thatch. Only reason why I'm using metal foundation, everything else metal, is because I could spawn it in for the purpose of the video. But you put down your main foundation where you want it to be. Then you put a pillar right down the middle. So of course it's gonna place normally. There you go. And then you're gonna see that because of that pillar. You can see right here, there's two snap points. The bottom one, which is the one you want to do. So you add that, boom. It instantly snaps down lower than the normal foundation. But this also gives you the option to actually place another foundation at the same height, which we could do now, but we're gonna wait. Now to lower this one even more, you actually put a pillar right here, and you gotta make sure it actually lower than that one. So in order to check, you guys go over here. If it doesn't snap lower than the one that's currently there, then it did not work. So it's gonna take some testing here and there. That's why I said you guys could use wooden pillars instead of this, because it'll waste a lot of resources if you cannot get it right. So you gotta make sure it's lowered. So let's see if we could actually get it. See, I think that is, no, that one's actually higher for some reason. That's the same height. What I did also, besides that, I tried to put it at the edge, because somehow when I put it at the edge, it came out lower. So see if we could do this. Yeah, you see how it's lower on that side? It's lower than the normal one. So there's like the snap points. It should drop any second. Like, let's see. If we put it, oh, there it is. Move, there you go, the lower snap point, put that, and now you can see it's actually lower than the first one, which gives you the ability to do this, and boom, and it lowers the snap point. So this simple tutorial, guys, I know it took me a while to actually get it properly, especially with the pillars. So make sure you use a really renewable resource like wood and stuff when you're practicing this. Of course, you could leave your main one as that and then just replace it with whatever you need. So let's see. Now we could continue doing this. So we're gonna go over here. We're gonna put the lower one. No, make sure it snaps the lower one. Sometimes it snaps back up. So the cool thing about this now, let's see, we can put, nope. See, look, it snapped to the top one. Because of that, we actually can't snap the rest because they're in the way. It's obstructed, so we could break this. As a matter of fact, we could actually do this. Let's break this pillar. You're fine to break the pillars because those structures are already in place. You can break all the pillars. Go up back here. Build the second layer on there. You could build, make sure it snaps properly, or else you're just gonna waste resources. So there you go. You guys see it has double layers right here. So there's two layers of foundations right here, two layers of foundations right here. And we'll start on the third layer right now. Let me just put this down. Let's try to get this the bottom snap. So you see it does snap between them. Boom. Could we manage to get the second one? It's a little glitchy. And then see, that's what I mean. You gotta be careful of how to do it. Oh, we're actually able to put it far in the distance. Let's see. It just takes a lot of practice. Of course, you're not going to be in fly mode when you do this, but it's still possible to do it without fly. So, boom, there you go. So now all these have triple layer foundations, which is insane because that's what 45,000 health right there. So if they throw a grenade and start doing damage, actually this one only has two. Oh yeah, this is the original one. So we could actually break this. Since the surrounding ones do have all three foundations in already, we were fine to break these. So here you go. So if they throw a grenade, they're gonna do damage to. I'm not sure if they do damage to the top one or like how it actually works, but it will take them longer to take down your buildings because you got all the extra support. So let's see if we could manage to snap. There you go. We snap that one. Can we snap that one to the low one? Yes. So do this, a little lag. Actually, see, we replace it. Boom. So yeah, that's gonna happen a lot if you're not careful, even on, because this is, like I said, we're on Xbox. This is Vanilla Ark, so that's how you know we're not using any mods, no cheats, only spawning the items in. But boom, now we got a 2x3 foundation layered in three, which is crazy because this is more protection than you need. And it will help a lot when it comes to PvP raiding if you guys, because you guys will probably still do this with stone and other things. Of course, it's best to do it with metal. You can actually tell. I haven't really done it with stone, but it's the best to show with metal. So let me actually put the command and switch this to nighttime, daytime. So it's, let me see, time set time of day 13. So that way we don't have to keep it at night. So there we go, we're back today. So yeah, that's a little tutorial on how to do the floors, the foundations, stacking them. This is how you would start off. You put the main one, put the pillar, put the second one on the second snap point, and try to adjust the second pillar to be lower than the first one. So once the second pillar is lower than the first one, then you're free to put it in and do the third one. So you could probably still keep going after this. Let's see. You gotta be careful with the snap points. You just gotta make sure it's, yeah, see, that's a lower snap point right there. You can actually tell. So it's a little complicated in how to get the lower snap points. Even if you do it right here on the outside, you're actually able to snap. I was able to snap it lower somehow. Let me see. Yeah, see right here, it shows it like halfway, but it's probably because of the terrain. But actually, because that one snapped lower, I think we could actually snap it next to it. No, see, it's kind of glitchy. See, these two are connected. This one's not low enough, but you could probably possibly get it lower, and it's just because of the terrain that's in the area. So that's possible. You could do them. I'm not sure how many layers. I think I've seen people do it up to like four layers. Let me just drop all this stuff of all the things we've been collecting. So you could probably do it down to four layers. The most I've generally seen is three, and that's already enough. Like double foundations is insane. triple foundations is even crazier. Imagine four foundations, just more protection for your base. Especially if you guys have all the resources to do this naturally, then go right ahead. This is a perfect way to defend your base. I know a lot of people who do PvP know this already. Some people don't, like me. I didn't know you could actually do it until like probably a couple days ago this week. But yeah, let's get into the walls. So with this, I'm pretty sure, let's see. So you could put the fence foundations. Let's put, you see there's always two snap points. I put on the furthest one out. Let's do this. Furthest one out. So I think you could put the wall naturally on the outside, which I think it's that one. Let's see. Let's make sure. And then you could, yeah, see. All right, that one replaces it, but let's try to get it onto the snap point. I think this is actually the harder part, I would say. Because there's multiple, and I mean multiple snap points to walls in this area. So we have two walls there. I have to see how I actually did it. I managed to get two walls in, which honestly, oh wait, because I put, where is it? Let's actually take down this wall. Sorry about this. This is actually what I did. I put the two, since there was two snap points, to put two different fence foundations. Let's do that. Put that one over that one. Then here, snap it on top. So now you have two fence foundations next to each other, which is pretty crazy because you wouldn't be able to tell. So now you could put the walls. Put that one down and put that one down. Nope, they snapped on the same foundation. It's very complicated, like, to get it precise. Because if you think about it, there is two fence foundations right here. And you're actually able to snap it on the inside. Come on. It's actually not cooperating for some reason. Here you will probably be able to see. There's outside snap points. And then, whoa, this is actually more complicated than it started. There though, look at this, look at this. Now it gives me the extra snap point. There you go. So you see in one fence foundation, there is two snap points. So you were able to put, I was able to put two walls there. Let's see if I could do that here perfectly. So let's see. We got, it's like you just got to get the right positioning. Let's see. No, that's not the right snap point. It's not giving me the proper snap point. I think we have to put it on there. Come on. It's just complicated because it is trying to snap onto this wall. Let's see. Face it there. Nope. Yeah, sometimes it gets extremely, extremely complicated to the point that you can't place the wall. I've had this issue with the first test. Oh, wait. No. It's just very hard. It's just trial and error. Of course, like I said, when you do it yourself, you have try to do it with actual like thatch foundations and then the wooden fence foundations and all this other stuff. So actually take them all down. Put the second one. And there you go. You can see, alright, there you go. Now we managed to do it. So we were able to put two walls on the outside. And that's crazy. So the way to add a third wall, you actually put the foundation there, like the extra foundation. You go here, you try to put it as close as possible to here, and then once that is down, you can actually put the wall. Let's see if we could put the wall closest. Oh, the snap point almost. So it's just a fact of messing with the snap points in the game. It's totally possible they wouldn't add this into the game if it wasn't. And I think I will be able to, no, let's put it on the, see, you gotta mess, right, here we go. Like these walls are so complicated. Let's put that on that snap point. Let's see if we could get the second. Yeah, we can't put the second fence foundation in, but you could actually go here, destroy the metal foundation and the third wall stage. You could kind of see the lip right here, but that's fine. You could probably put a ramp and stuff to protect it, like facing down to protect that foundation. But now you got triple layer walls on this side. Do that here also. Fence foundation, could we put the second one? Yes, actually, that's what we should have done here. So let's see if we can actually manage to put four walls as defense. So let's see. It's a matter of where are you aiming, you know? So there's one there, and boom, there you go. So now you got four layer walls, break the foundation, and boom, there you go. Now you got four layer walls. That time I was only supposed to, I wasn't able to do three. Here I was only able to do three because I didn't do it properly. Let's do this. I think we could still put the front. No, we have to break the fence foundation in order to, let's see, let's do this. Could we get the fence foundation? Yes. Just hope we don't break. All right, good. We didn't break everything. So let's do this. Put the, what's happening? Oh, did we not? Oh, we didn't. We broke the wrong foundation. Oh my God. Let's see. It is going all sorts of wrong. Sorry, guys. Let's see. Put the foundation. No. There we go. No. That's the thing. You got to watch it with the snap points of the fence foundations. Do that one. And then there's the second one. Let's put the walls back in. Let's see. There you go with second one. That one actually went up a little higher for some reason. Put that one, and then we are actually able to put the outside wall closer in. And there you go. So one wall did come out higher, just the way I put it. But that's still fine because now you have actually extra snap points. So now it's a full four-layer wall on both sides. So you just take that out. And now, as you can see, there is no lip showing. It's like very, very smooth. You can still put stuff on the outside, like put a ramp to just defend and make it better so they don't see all the fence foundations. But that's how you layer walls, like triple, quadruple layer walls. I didn't think I was actually going to be able to put four layers of walls on here. I've seen people, they're actually able to do more. Like, imagine, someone's going to blow through the first wall, like draw a C4 not knowing. They're only going to blow through the first one, and then they have another wall, another one, another wall. So you could actually do the exact same thing with door frames and, of course, hatch frames. That way you go have multiple doors. So if they break one door, the second one's still there, and then third and fourth and so on and so forth, which is extremely good for base defending. So imagine having the three fence the three foundations with four layer walls on top. That's going to be insane for you to defend with. And then, like I did, you can see I do have the crossed walls. It's as easy as doing this. Let's see. It's literally just crossing. If we could get the right snap point here. Let's see. Let's actually raise ourselves. There's multiple snap points there too, as you can see. And then I do that one. Let's see which one we could actually get that one done. Could I actually do multiple snap points at that in this position? This is actually the hard thing to do. Actually, ooh, we actually might be able to do multiple snap points here. We're not gonna be able to do that one. I actually had trouble. I've seen people do it, but I haven't mastered that little section of being able to put multiple. So this is just gonna override itself. But you can see there, we got that wall. Is down. We can't put the second one. We're gonna have to mess with these snap points. But there you go. Now you got four layers of wall. That's five, six layers. Basically, you got six. No, this is actually 8, 9, 10 layers of walls. If you think about it. So if they try to break through from here, they have to break through four layers on each side, and then they have to break through this one. So if I could get the proper snap points in the future, we could probably. I think I've seen people layer like two walls right here. Like there's two crossing walls. And they just keep going. So then you could literally just box this out like this and make a hole like enforced, and then just keep that going for next foundation, the next foundation, next foundation. And you could easily do that for your whole outer wall. And then you, of course, you could build all the walls on top, as you guys could see. So let's actually try to do that. So let's get this. As you see, it will be extremely hard. You have to try to get all those simple snap points. Like, look, it still snaps on the outside. So yeah. So let's see. Ooh. So it's like just the way you're looking at it, it's gonna be the hardest thing. So to get those extra walls up, it's just gonna take some time, take some practice, because it's not gonna be the first try. You saw it took me a while just to get it on the first try. So look at that. We got that. We just need one more wall. Within, and ooh, that one actually showed it. There you go. Now we got four walls too high. So that's crazy. And then all I have to do is this one within here. To see. I think it showed the snap. It's like you just gotta be very, very patient with this. I'm putting it. And there you go. No. Oh my gosh. Wait. Yeah, as you can see, it is not the easiest task in the world. But if you have the patience to do this, it's going to help a lot when it comes to getting raided and stuff. You won't get raided as crazy. So look at that. You just keep stacking walls. I'm not able to get this fourth wall in here, which is very, very odd. But that's fine. And let's see. Let's actually do this over here, and I will show you guys. No, I'll do this. I'll do that for a separate video. I'll show you guys how to do the ceilings and probably door frames if you guys enjoy this video. So if you guys enjoyed this video, drop a like down below. If you guys have any questions on how to do this like more in depth, I'll try to make another video. If we get at least, if we go hit 10 likes on this video, I will make a part two showing you guys how to do the how to do it all together, like basically putting the triple layer foundations with like 2-3 layers of walls on top of that, with the multiple layers of ceilings and doorways. So you're gonna have a crazy impenetrable base, and then we can actually test it out by like putting C4 and grenades on there. So with that, if you guys enjoyed the video, drop a like down below, comment what you guys want to see future videos, and subscribe if you haven't already seen more content on the channel. With that, we'll see you guys next video. Goodbye.